This lesson is all about asking questions. Problems, questions, and curiosity are what science is all about. A good scientist can ask a good question, and they ask questions based on what they see. Then they do an experiment, and experiments are just questions that are asked to find some answers. So experiments ask questions and find answers. So how do scientists recognize a problem? Well, they look at the world around them. So the questions that are asked come from observations that make you wonder why something happens or how something happens. But basically, if you look at the world around you, you're going to start to ask questions or recognize problems. Scientific problems are just questions. So when we talk about a scientific problem, all we're meaning is a question that can be asked or is asked. So problems in terms of science usually answer the questions as what? So what happens? Or how? How will that be different if I do this? Why does something happen? Or when will this happen? Or when will something occur? So for example, what brand of mouthwash kills the most germs would be a scientific problem. Which car shape is the best for speed? So would it be a pointed nose, a flat nose? All of these are types of things that scientists might ask. Which coffee has the most caffeine? Which phone case is the best for protecting my phone? Again, scientists aren't the only people that ask questions or have problems. There are large-scale problems, such as how can we make less pollution? These are things that lots of people are involved with. Even the entire country or the entire world are asking these questions. There are also large-scale problems like what material is the best for icy roads? Here in Windsor, they're looking at replacing salt with beet juice. So that's a question that is large scale because it's an entire city trying to come up with a solution. Why do some people get cancer? This is a question that a lot of scientists are answering or asking and trying to find an answer to. Then there are smaller scale problems, such as how can I make sure I'm on time for school? Again, the problem is just the question. It's not trying to come up with an answer yet. Just asking the question. Why isn't my Wi-Fi working? That would be a scientific problem. There are two major types of questions. The first is known as a research question. This type of question can be answered pretty simply, and they're facts that can be found in a book or online, such as, what is gum made out of? You could put that into Google, up would pop the answer, and you'd be done. You have answered your question. Then there are what are called experimental questions. And these can be tested to find an answer. So something has to be done. And in the testing of it, something needs to be changed in one thing to find an answer. So for example, what type of gum blows the biggest bubble? What needs to be changed is the type of gum. So you could test Trident versus Hubba Bubba versus Excel. You'd be changing the type of gum and you would actually be doing a test or experimenting to find your answer. So what I would like you to do is pause the video right now and in your note template, write down two research questions and two experimental questions about Massey. So this can be about our school as a whole, about the students, but two research and two experimental questions. Now that you have your questions, let's take a quick look at what actually makes a good scientific question. Well, a good scientific question has what is called a real answer, meaning that it's not a yes or a no. Do you like chocolate? Yes. That's not a good scientific question. Why do people like chocolate? That would be a real question. Good scientific questions are testable, meaning that you could have a set of steps and you could actually do something to find out the answer, okay? Good scientific questions, you don't just go online and Google and find the answer, okay? They're experimental questions or good scientific questions. And good scientific questions are interesting. It's something you want to actually find out or know the answer to, okay? So what I'd like you to do is look at the two experimental questions you wrote about Massey. Are your experimental questions good scientific questions? Explain why they are or why they aren't. If they're not good scientific questions based on the criteria from the previous slide, How could you change them to make them good experimental questions? I'd like you to do that now as we end this lesson.